did you have an encounter with Mr. Fuzzbutt, a.k.a. Bigfoot, a.k.a. Sasquatch or Sabe? If so, I want to hear about it. So does the rest of the world. So what are you waiting for? Put the details of your encounter down into an email and send it to contact@BuckeyeBigfoot.com. Welcome back to Buckeye Bigfoot. Hello there, everyone. I do hope everyone is doing well. You know, winter just keeps grinding on and on here down in the Miami Valley of Ohio. But I know that a lot of my listeners out there, you're probably grinding on and on through summer. Well, wherever you are, I do hope you're doing well and you've got lots of snackage lined up because we're about to hit the trail and head down into Sasquatch Valley. Which, by the way, regarding Sasquatch Valley, I just was immediately hooked recently on a production by Small Town Monsters right here on YouTube. Their recent video production was titled Sasquatch Valley. Now, you know I had to watch it. And for the record, no, I'm not affiliated with any of them. I don't even know them as far as I'm aware. This isn't a coordinated plug. I just wanted to mention it because the whole thing was really interesting. And I've liked a lot of their work in the past. So, you know, Sasquatch Valley is a thing here. And I was glad to see someone else use it too. So, of course, I just had to mention it. All right, now speaking of the valley, let's go ahead and get saddled up and move on out. We've got a lot of miles to trot through to get there. And it's starting to get dark really fast. And you know, where there's darkness, there could very well be a Sasquatch or two lurking around in there, and you just can't see them. Back in the late 90s, we had to move to White Oak because we lost our home. We had an outside bathroom. I went to the outhouse, and when I came out, I stood still and stretched. I saw a hairy Bigfoot rise up in the field beside our house. It took 3 steps and just vanished. It was a broom sage color. The hair was about 6 inches long on its body, and it had a tan face. It was about 8 to 9 feet tall. I told my husband and my son. They believed me. One night, my son went to visit our neighbors that lived right below us. He came back home late. I heard him running hard and fast. I opened our front door. He came busting through it. He was pale, and his heart was running away with him. He told us what happened. We shined our flashlights, but did not see anything. That winter, the Bigfoot chased my son into the house after he shot a rabbit. There was a large footprint, and we found the dead rabbit the next morning. We were very careful. The Bigfoot moved on after that. Signed, Barbara. Regarding this next encounter, I'm not sure. I feel like I have read this for the channel already, but it was still sitting in my inbox. I went back through the last couple months. I didn't see it in any video description or in my records. But keep in mind, I lost an awful lot when I lost that external hard drive when I moved, so I can't be sure. So, if this has been read before, I do apologize. After so many hundreds, I kind of lose track. Anyway, here is the email. This was in the summer of 1976 or 77. It was church camp for Salvation Army. Just call me Johnny. I told you about my encounter in Belmont County, a pinch run. I wasn't sure to even tell this one. The camp is still in use. It's not much of anything scary or anything, but here we go. There was a bunch of us boys that hung out. We thought we were the cool kids. We were all about the same ages, 11 to 13. There were about 12 of us kids. We were up on top of the hill, just hanging out in the woods being boys. It was about 8 or 9 a.m., just after breakfast. We all had sticks, and we were swinging and hitting rocks. Then, out of nowhere, we hear a big knock. It made us all jump. We all looked around at each other like, who did it? And we were all like, not me. So we kept walking. Then a chipmunk ran by us, and like boys, we ran after it. And as we were in hot pursuit, the chipmunk, running like mad kids, I look over to my right. That was up the hill about 50 yards or so. I screamed, what is that big thing? It was running parallel to us. At first, none of the other guys paid any attention to me. Then little Joey saw it, and he screamed, everyone run! It's a monster! It was funny and scary at the same time. The Bigfoot stopped and hid behind a big tree. We looked, and we saw him peek out at us. We all screamed and then ran down the hill. And no, we never ran off again. From what I remember, I'm guessing the big guy was between 7 to 8 feet tall, and he had all black hair. I couldn't make out his face, it was too far away. But that was the last year that I went to church camp. I got a girlfriend and stayed in town. Never saw any of those guys again. I hope one of them hears this and says, I was one of the gang. P.S. As you know, Zanesville is just a few miles south of the church camp. Signed, Johnny. Hi, Nance. I listen to your show almost every night. It helps me get to sleep, but I always play back the ones that I fell asleep to. Your storytelling is relaxed and atmospheric. Anyway, let's get to these encounters that I've had. Some about me. My name's Floyd. I'm 32 now. I'm your average hard worker, husband, and father. I just work hard for my kids. I've moved a lot in my life, but I've always lived in Maryland and once in Virginia. These two states vary where it has cities and thick woods and also some very rural areas. The first encounter. I was about 12 years old, which makes it around 2000 to 2001. I never ever thought about Bigfoot before. It was in Montgomery County, Maryland. I lived in an area that was once all woods, but development changed it. It became more of a mini-city style surrounded by woods on the outside of it. There was still plenty of areas where changes haven't been made. We would get on our bikes and ride through the woods to reach our spot. It would take about 15 minutes to reach on a bike. This spot had a really big slope in it, and we would do jumps off of it with our bikes. It was a pretty thick, secluded patch of woods. It also had a swamp right next to the slope. It had a weird smell some days, but nothing really unbearable. It was a really sloped area, and the swamp had cattails and other bushes and plants around it. Very tall trees surrounded the entire area. But it was not that far from the houses when I think back to it. The developments must have really messed with the woods creatures. Anyway, me and my friends would go there almost every day and do bike jumps. The slope was big. I'd say it dropped about 30 feet, then went straight for 10 feet, then ramped up 6 feet. So it was like a perfect jump spot for bikes. However, at first, I was too afraid to go down it. Like I said, and this was a large jump slope for a 10-year-old, in my opinion. One day, I went by myself to finally do it without the pressure of my friends. I was there for about 20 minutes, trying to build up the confidence. Because I still felt like someone was watching, I kept looking around, and there was nothing. On top of that, the weird smell was present on this day. But that was normal. We always just figured it's just the smell of the swamp or the pond, which could be true. I finally built the confidence to do the jump, and I did it. And I did it very smooth. It was a perfect jump. I celebrated out loud to myself because I finally did it. And I was very proud of myself. I expressed it some out loud. That's when I noticed that someone was indeed watching me. Right by the swamp in front of a tree and behind cattails near the swamp, someone was clearly looking at me in interest. At first, I thought that it was an adult human. But as I looked more, I suddenly had no idea what was looking directly at me. And why would any adult human just stand there in that area looking at me? It had flowing hair around the face from what I could see. And it was huge, maybe 7 feet tall, because it was over the cattails, which were growing pretty darn tall at the time. Anyone who's seen them should know they grow pretty tall sometimes. Whatever it was, it seemed to be almost studying my behavior of celebration and excitement. Then it knew that I was looking at it, too. I'm going to address it as an it. It stared at me for 30 seconds more as I stood in shock. If it decided to chase me, it would definitely catch me, as I would have to either run through the tight woods or run up the 30-foot slope. A bike would not help my speed here. But it didn't go after me. It slowly turned around and went behind the trees. But I could still see a tall, shadowy figure. It was standing still with very slow sways. I never got a great look at it. I picked my bike up and slowly began. But when I took my very first step towards my bike, I heard a deep growl or a sound that resembled one. And right there, I swore I was in a dream, or should I say nightmare. I decided to slowly backpedal my steps in a very non-aggressive manner. I needed to get out of there. I kept backing away slowly, trying not to be frantic. It didn't move at all or make any noise. It just watched me again as a dark shadow figure, just staring. Maybe it thought I was going to go toward it at first. Maybe that's why it growled. I don't know. I took my eyes off of it for a moment while getting myself back up the slope jump. And it was gone. So I started racing out of there, pedaling as fast as I could, talking to myself to keep calm. I started hearing snapping and branches breaking to the left of me. I looked, and again I could only get glimpses of a shadow that was shadowing me through the trees. But it actually seemed like it was walking and keeping up with my bike. It was really fast for sure. For a second, I thought I had seen it run on all fours. But I'm not sure. I was panicking, but it actually never got close to me. When I reached the tree line, I went out like 50 feet. This was now right near some houses, and I felt pretty safe, so I listened for it. And sure enough, the shadow came to the tree line. It stared at me. Then it turned around and disappeared quickly. Thinking back, now that I'm older, when it was staring at me at the end, I didn't feel a threat. I think it was interested in me and my behavior. Maybe it was lonely or something. I still wasn't thinking Bigfoot until this point. But thinking back, it showcased intelligence, and it knew not to go near the houses. I can't shake the feeling that it looked really sad and curious. It had a grayish face from what I remember. It's a blur, and I couldn't be so sure. The only aggressive part was when I think it thought that I was going to charge with my speed bike at it. Everything else seemed curious and distant. Do you think it was sad? I felt like it was a very sad presence that crept into me also. Maybe the developments had ruined its home. Maybe it became lost. I'm not sure there was a saddening feel surrounding that experience, rather than a scary one. I think that maybe that guy was nice. I went on Google Maps to this spot recently to see why and how it could be so close to this area. I found that it connected to a really big thick of woods called Seneca Park. You can look it up in Maryland. You could easily get lost in those woods, and they lead to more wood areas. Nothing out there but woods. Now, in the future, they have added more developments in the area. The poor guy or girl or whatever that thing was, it had to be sad and lonely. It just had that heavy feel for some reason, and it wasn't aggressive. I never saw it again. However, I've never gone back alone, only with friends. My second encounter. Now, this one was different because I was about 18 and I had moved out on my own to Front Royal, Virginia. There were mountains and rivers and nothing but woods all around me. I lived in a very secluded place where bears and cougars were even a thing. The Shenandoah River was across the way from my little cozy house. The view was beautiful there, absolutely beautiful. When the sun rose over that river with the mountain in sight, it was beautiful, especially when it was fall, with the orange, the yellow, and the red leaves spreading along the mountain and the sun above and the Shenandoah River below. Anyway, I was at the house with just my two dogs, and every night my dogs would bark and growl at the window. I was alone, so I thought it might be an intruder. Every night, this consistently happened around the same time. I had no thoughts of Bigfoot. I was thinking more about weird people. I would hear branches cracking in the woods around my house, and they sounded like big branches because they were very loud snaps with tears. One night, there was a tapping on the window, and my dogs always barked at it. Light tapping. I turned the lights off in my house so I could see out. A shadow figure moved away from the window, and it was a very tall figure. I decided I had had enough of this, so I went outside with my dogs. They were Pit Bull Mix and German Shepherd Rottweiler Mix. We just stood there, and nothing was there. There was just an eerie silence. I sat for about 10 minutes, just relaxing on the front porch. Our road had no street lights at all, so it was pitch black out. I went back in for safety reasons. All I know is it was a very large figure. Inhuman. I was scared, but sick of being harassed. Once again, I felt this thing was just very curious. I hoped. Possibly tapping on the window just to get the dogs and me to react to it. But this went on for weeks. I would hear crazy noises that I've never heard before in the woods. Nothing dramatic happened, though. I moved out of there quickly, to be honest. It was getting creepy. It was certainly a more aggressive approach than my first encounter, and I felt like the bravery of it was building up. It was time to move back to Maryland. The third encounter. Well, it's not much of an encounter, but a visual of something on a tree farm. Me and my wife were driving on a back road and passed a tree farm. And my wife was like, "Look, look, what the heck is that?" I was driving, so it took me a minute to look. I saw an animal running, which appeared to be running like a gorilla, on all fours again. It was going the speed of my car, which was like 35 miles per hour. It made a sharp turn and disappeared. My wife was literally speechless at what we saw. I told her that I think I have seen a Bigfoot running on all fours before. She believes me to an extent, but she can't explain what we saw. Well, Nance, I hope my stories were good. These were 100% real. Whether it was Bigfoots or not, something was not normal. I love your show and many of the stories on it. Be sure to check out that area that I mentioned in the first encounter to see how it could end up there. If you look closely around that area, you can see how something could go a long way in the woods there. And keep in mind, years back, there were far less developments. Maryland and Virginia are underrated for possible sightings. Some of these areas, anyone could get lost. I do hope you've enjoyed all of them. Signed, Floyd. Well, I think I can speak for everyone. We've enjoyed all of them. I appreciate everyone who did take the time to send their encounters in. I enjoyed them all. And as always, if you've got an encounter, don't keep it to yourself. Those days are long, long gone. All right, everyone. Well, I'm going to wrap it up for tonight. So until we do meet up again, always remember, absence of proof is not proof of absence. Thanks for listening, everyone. Have a great weekend.